Hello students, Unit 4 Electromagnetic Induction and Alternating Current Continuation Video. In our previous class, we learned about LC oscillation. If suppose I considered a tank circuit consisting of inductor of inductance L and capacitor of capacitance C. If suppose I applied an energy to the tank circuit, then the energy will oscillate back and forth with a particular definite frequency. Okay, that is known as LC oscillation. Here let we compare the LC oscillation with the simple harmonic motion. Okay, so we know in our 11th standard we seen lot of mechanical system. Here let we compare this LC oscillation system with a mechanical system. Okay, so I consider a spring mass system. Spring mass system, this is a mechanical system. Okay, I consider a spring that is rigidly supported by the stand, then it is connected with a mass m having the force constant k or spring constant k. Okay, if suppose it is compressed or extended, it attain a force. Okay, then the force experienced by the mass is F is equal to ma, and the force experienced by the spring, that is F is equal to minus kx. Here x is a displacement. Okay, these two forces are same, so we can equate these two, then we get ma is equal to minus kx. Okay, here a is a acceleration. Okay, in order to write this equation in terms of displacement, so I am considering the acceleration as displacement. That is, we know acceleration is a first order derivative of velocity. We know velocity is a first order derivative of displacement. So we can write acceleration a is equal to d by dt. This v became dx by dt. Okay, this one can be written as a is equal to d square x by dt square. Okay, so acceleration became d square x by dt square, that is equal to minus kx. Okay, we know the equation for simple harmonic motion, that is d square x by dt square is equal to minus omega square x. Okay, compare with this, then we get d square x by dt square is equal to minus k by m x. So we can write these two things are similar, so we can write omega is equal to root of k by m. Okay, here omega is the angular frequency of the oscillation of the spring mass system. Okay, angular frequency. Okay, if suppose we need a frequency, then F is equal to 1 by 2 pi root of k by m. Okay, we know omega is equal to 2 pi F. And after solving this, this one will be the frequency. So, the next I consider here, this is a spring mass system, that is a mechanical system. Then I am going for a electrical system. Okay, that is LC oscillator. Okay, so far I consider LC oscillator. This oscillator consists of capacitor of capacitance C and inductor of inductance L. If suppose I apply an energy E in the tank circuit or the oscillator, then the energy will oscillate back and forth with a definite frequency, that is F is equal to 1 by 2 pi root of LC. Okay, then the angular frequency is omega is equal to 1 by root of LC. Okay, so this omega is, that is similar to the omega is equal to root of k by m. Okay, by comparing these two equation, we have a term that mass can be equated to inductance, and the term K is equal to 1 by C. Okay, let me see. We know the spring mass system omega is equal to root of K by M, and for the electrical system, that is LC oscillator, then omega is equal to 1 by root of LC. Okay, on comparing these two equations, we get the mass of the body in the spring mass system, that is equal to inductance of the inductor in the electrical system, and the value of K, that is a force constant, is a reciprocal of capacitance of the electrical system. Okay, so here I am comparing the two energy. Okay, that means I am comparing the energies in two oscillator system. Okay, comparison of energies in two oscillatory system. First of all, I am considering the LC oscillator system. Okay, for LC oscillator system, there are two elements. One is capacitor. Okay, then next one is inductor. So the energy stored in the capacitor, we know that is UE is equal to half Q square by C, and the energy stored in the inductor, that is UB, is equal to half LI square. Okay, I already mentioned this. See, this energy stored in a capacitor is a which type of energy? That is a electrostatic potential energy. Okay, here the energy stored in the inductor, that is a electrodynamic energy. Okay, then next shall we go for a spring mass system. Spring mass system. Okay, for that we are considering the two elements, that is spring and mass. Spring and mass. Okay, for that case, the energy stored in a spring, that is known as potential energy, that is equal to 1 by 2 kx square. Okay, you already studied in your 11th standard. Then the energy stored in a mass, that is a kinetic energy, that we know half mv square. Okay, on comparing these two equation, we get a knowledge, that is the charge Q, that is equal to the displacement x. Okay, see, this is Q square, this is x square. We know very well C is a reciprocal of K, or K is a reciprocal of C. Okay, see, two system, first it is electrical system, then this one is mechanical system. Okay, on comparing these two, we get the charge Q, that is similar to the displacement x in mechanical system. Okay, then next, see, the current I square, here V square. So the current I is similar to the velocity V. We know current can be written as dQ by dt. Then the displacement velocity can be written as dx by dt. We know the mass, that is play a similar role as the inductance. Okay, so mass, here it is inductance, sorry, here it is inductance, here it is mass. Okay, then we know the reciprocal of capacitance is equal to force constant. Okay, or we can write C is proportional to 1 by K. Okay, then electrical energy, that we know which one? This one. Okay. Electrical energy, that means the energy stored in a capacitor, that is equal to the energy of the spring, that is potential energy. Okay. Then magnetic energy, that is equal to kinetic energy of the mass. Okay. Then the total energy for this system. Okay. That we know very well, that is U is equal to 1 by 2 Q square by C plus 1 by 2 Li square. Okay. For this case, the total energy, that is U, is equal to 1 by 2 Kx square plus 1 by 2 Mb square. Okay. Then let me check the LC oscillator system is SHM or not. Okay. Let me see a qualitative approach to prove the electrical oscillation system is a SHM. Okay. In order to prove it is SHM, so it have to give this relation. Okay. That is d square x by dt square is equal to minus omega square x. Okay. If this relation satisfies, then the electrical oscillation is a SHM, that is simple harmonic motion. Okay. We know the energy of a electrical system, that is total energy of electrical system, that is E is equal to half Q square by C plus half L I square. Okay. This is the energy of the electrical system. Here I am differentiating this equation. Okay. Because it is a differential equation, so I am differentiating this equation with respect to time, then dE by dt, that is equal to then 1 by 2 C, this one became 2Q dQ by dt, then this one half L 2I dI by dt. Okay. Here differentiating a constant one, we get 0, that is equal to cancelling this, we get Q by C, then dQ by dt is I. Okay. Rate of flow of charge is current, plus this 2 also cancelled, then I by L dI by dt. Okay. We know I is equal to dQ by dt. So Q by C I plus I by L d by dt, then this I became dQ by dt. Okay. That is 0. Then Q by C I plus I by L d square Q by dt square. Okay. Then take the I as a common, then 0 is equal to I Q by C plus 1 by L d square Q by dt square. Okay. Then I becomes 0, then we can write this one as 1 by L d square Q by dt square is equal to minus Q by C. Again solve this, then d square Q by dt square is equal to minus Q by LC. Okay. Then we can compare this equation with this equation. We know omega square is equal to 1 by LC. So we can write d square Q by dt square is equal to minus omega square Q. Okay. So this electrical system that obey simple harmonic motion. Okay. See, this one is d square q by dt square is equal to minus omega square q. Here also for the mechanical system, that is d square x by dt square is equal to minus omega square x. Okay. So this electrical system also a simple harmonic system. Okay. Okay, students, lesson 4. electromagnetic induction and alternating current is completed. Here in today's class, we learnt about oscillation in LC circuit. Okay, LC oscillation is nothing but an oscillation produced by the energy when the energy is applied to the LC circuit. Okay, that oscillation is known as LC oscillation. Then we found the conservation of energy in LC oscillation also, and then next to the last topic is we compared the LC oscillation system with a mechanical system, and also it is an SHM motion. We found it is an SHM motion. Okay, then this is our today's assignment. Here I gave one short answer, that means very short answer question, that is what are LC oscillation. The next followed by that three long answer question. Question number 24, that is from your book bag. Okay, explain the generation of LC oscillation in a circuit containing an inductor of inductance L and capacitor of capacitance C. Okay, that is in page number 251 right side. Then question number 25, it is prove that the total energy is conserved during LC oscillation. It is the easy one, that three cases. Okay, that is in page number 253 left side. Then last question, that is compare the electromagnetic oscillation of LC circuit with the mechanical system of block spring system qualitatively to find the expression for angular frequency of LC oscillator, page number 253. Okay, for this question I also give the quantitative approach also. Okay, okay students, complete the assignment on time. Thank you.